Okay, so here we are with the preview, the Call of Duty live stream. This was one of the first, this was from day two of the Call of Duty. I know there was a 3-day event and everything going on, but I just grabbed some day two footage. I didn't catch too much of the day three stuff, so right here. Anyways, this is what they called the Pro Boot Camp, where they brought in some pro teams from over in the UK and the US. There was TK there, there's Epsilon, there was Curse, there was all kinds of them there, and they brought all the pros together to play, Advanced Warfare, to check it out, to show off for the fans and everything. Right here, you can see the brand new game mode. It's a lot. I thought it was going to be a little more like a football game, but it's actually not too bad. It's kind of like a basketball game, to tell the truth, more or less. Like a, I don't know, a capture the flag meets basketball, I guess, with guns. It was good, though. It was good. I just, tell the truth, I think Advanced Warfare, I mean, everybody, y'all need your own opinions on this game, on every game. Don't let us YouTubers persuade you. Everybody should have their own opinion, which usually 9 times out of 10 everybody has their own very strong opinions on stuff. But from my opinion, I would say Advanced Warfare is getting a good thumbs up for me. It's brand new. It still feels like Call of Duty. Yes, there is stuff from other games mashed together in with this one, which, I mean, you know what? That's not so much a bad thing, I would say, though, because it brings probably some of the best elements from other games into one realm, into one of the biggest franchises that there is in gaming history. Yes, okay, people are gonna be pissed at me saying that, but you know what? It's true. Get over it. So yeah, Advanced Warfare, a lot of new tools, a lot of new gadgets, a lot of new perks, a lot of new everything. This game, I mean, we've seen other games do the stuff that that Advanced Warfare does. The thing is, though, for the series, for the Call of Duty series itself, I think this is a brand new, fresh, revamp, recharge, retake on the whole Call of Duty experience. Sledgehammer is definitely raising the bar for Call of Duty with this game. Of the Call of Duty series, it could be the best of the series. It could be, the thing that refreshes the series, brings back a lot of fans that were put off by Ghosts, and a lot of fans that have just given up on the series because they say it's the same thing over and over and over again. If you think that this game, I mean, this is, again, this is my opinion on it. If you think this game is the exact same game as all the other Call of Duties, I mean, give me a break, look at it. The exo suit is totally changing up the game itself. You got just some of the different gadgets and whatnot, like care packages and stuff like that. Of course they're going to keep stuff like that in there because that is what makes Call of Duty what Call of Duty is. The game modes, yeah, of course they're going to keep those game modes too, because guess what? Every other game's copied off from some, of those game modes in one way or the other. Because they are popular game modes. The weapons, I mean, there's not like M4s, ACRs, AK-47s running around, This is like, I don't know if it's a near future, what the storyline was to it or whatever, but cause, the story, in matter of fact, I want to point that out too. The single player on this game looks absolutely like just, it's stunning, the graphics. The graphics on this thing are amazing. And for a Call of Duty game to look as good as it does on the single player, that really blew me away. That was really surprising right there. That it was really, really cool seeing that the next gen or the current gen or the Xbox One graphics shining the way they did at the single player trailer release thing that they had going on for Gamescom. But back to the multiplayer. It's just, I mean, wow. You know, like, when you think that Call of Duty's dead now, when you think it's about ready to probably be kaput, and then they come back with just, it's like a right hook to everybody's face, and in the way of, like, here, boom, we got you. We're going to do this, and you guys should be I'm blown. I don't know what I'm trying to say right now. Like, I'm like watching the gameplay as I'm talking right here, and it's just like, I'm thinking to myself, like, this, you know, could actually revamp the series. And like I said, recharge it and refresh it and everything. Because I think we've been missing that a lot in Call of Duty over the last couple few games. The last couple few games has been more or less just like, give everybody a map with three routes or four routes, and you hold down the side of the map, and you're fighting over the middle and everything. And to me, that really got stale. And I think to a lot of people, it really just got like, meh. Like, okay, yeah, you can grab a team, you can hold down the side of a map. Woo. Whoop-de-doo for that. You can sit on your butt in the back of the map and hold down your side of the map, and hopefully, you know, if you're a good team, you can get a bunch of kills, or you can get the objective and hold down that side of the map. Yeah, come on. Come on. You know, that's not really so much really competitive. What we're seeing with Advanced Warfare, it is, because you're not just having people. Yes, there is the, occasional sitting in a corner, because sometimes that is a decent tactic to use. But you're not going to be seeing it all the time in this one, or at least, hopefully not. Because, I mean, let's be honest, the way the general public likes to play Call of Duty and first-person shooters nowadays is camp out every spot that you can find to camp out. Double jumps and all that stuff, it gives you a lot more spots to camp out. But if you look at these maps, though, there's almost like three levels to each map. You got the lower level, you got that, you know, that second up, like mid-level where, there's, like, you got your tunnels on the lower level and everything that you can run through, and there's like five different passageways to the objective there and in the other spawn. You got your mid-level that's got like five different entryways from like the windows of maybe that building or whatever. And then you got the roof too, because now you got the double jump, so you can jump up there and you can shoot in from up top and whatnot. So, and the other thing too on this, if anybody says, well, that's it, that's all it's got to offer, this is just an early, thing. We got a few months left to go here. So, with that being said, there is other stuff that they have not shown in this Pro Boot Camp. If you're listening to the commentators, if you watch, the live stream and whatnot, you're listening to the commentators, they told everybody that this is not all that Sledgehammer has for this Call of Duty. There's going to be a lot more to come, and there's going to be a lot more guns, there's going to be a lot more different customizations and everything. You'll be able to see a lot more different class setups and everything being built. And the other thing, too, is it doesn't really seem like, and going into class setups and everything, it doesn't really seem like anything's really too OP, overpowered, whatever. This game really does seem like they tried to focus in on balancing and everything. It's almost like, dare I say it, and I know that the hardcore Call of Duty fans are probably going to want to try and whine about this if I do say this right here, but I forget what their names are. I'm bad with names. But the guys behind Sledgehammer, the two guys that you see always introducing the game and all that, they almost seem like they're on top of their game when it comes to Call of Duty, like Weston's Impala was back when they were doing COD 4 and back when they were doing MW2 and everything. Like, these two guys, this is from the Pro Boot Camp, so there's one of the pro teams right there. This is I kind of grabbed this footage off the live stream of the esports live stream and all that stuff. So you are definitely watching the pros, as you can see, playing this. So yeah, this is Curse Gaming right here. And of course, this, I think this is a game. No, it's the next game afterwards. But this was just them playing the objective game, just figuring the game out and everything. And of course, you know, like I said, this game mode right here, I guess, like, somebody, I read somewhere on, I think it was Twitter, that somebody said that this game mode was kind of jacked at Halo. Like I said, are they going to jack game modes out from other games? Sure. Have other games jack game modes out from them? Yes, they have. So it's like, you know, this is, it's kind of one of those things, like, game companies have to do that because people love certain types of game modes. So of course the game company is going to take those game modes that people love and they're going to use it in their games also. I think it's this brand new game mode, throwing the balls through the hoop and everything. I'm a basketball fan. I like that. I think it's pretty cool and everything. Especially when you can hit like a 3-point shot and get the 2 points up on the board with, you know what I'm saying, by a 3-point shot, like be way back there, chuck that ball, get it in, get the 2 points, or get the 1 point up on the board. It's 2 points if you jump in, that's right too. But that can be so crazy at the end of the game, like the clock's running down and you're coming up and it's tie game and then boom, you get that point and whatnot, and it just, you get, it wins that victory for your team. I mean, can you, you know, just think of that for a second on, like, wow, that could actually bring Call of Duty back. The esports thing, too. I want to say that esports and Call of Duty mesh so well. Like, when I was watching Advanced Warfare, it made me want to go and play Ghost. And that was a feeling that I haven't had in a long time with any shooter. Watching the esports pros and watching those guys just run around and do a very highly competitive game and not just see like the regular public that likes to usually sit back and keep the games at a slow pace for some reason. It just, you know, it felt really good to see really high pace, really high stakes, all for nothing, going for broke, you know what I'm trying to say. The esports mixed in with that also brings this competitive edge. Now, you know, not to over-competitive it, because I feel like the Clan Wars, that's what the Clan Wars really did, was it just made it so, like, over-competitive where everybody was trying to get with the clans. Like, Ghost, I think, part of the reason why Ghost is kind of flopped so much with the majority of the public was that clan thing. And if you really think about it, what did clans, the clans part of it really do? It made us play game types that we didn't want to play. It made us do stuff that we didn't want to do. It just, it made us get on the game at certain hours when we didn't really want to. I mean, me, if you watch, some of the earliest Call of Duty videos I did on here when I first started doing this channel, about, a few months ago. I'm on like 4 months now going to the channel. But when some of the very first Call of Duty videos I put up on the channel, I was running with a team. And I still actually, I probably am going to throw up some throwback. I think maybe some Black Ops 2. I don't know. I got some throwback clips anyways from Call of Duty. But that's when Black Ops 2 was when I started with my old team. And then we went right up through Ghosts and everything. But like I said, the clan ops thing is just like, it's fun to try and go for the wins and everything. It's just not fun the way they had it set up. I really did not like it. So this game right here, on Advanced Warfare, this is, I just noticed, it switched over to the game where they're just pretty much having fun. The pros are just playing around with every single tool that they can find to play around with. So you're going to be seeing the pistol action right there. You're going to be seeing some sniper action. You're going to be seeing, some, Yeah, dual light machine guns and all this. I mean, what other Call of Duty do you know has a what was it, a bolt action or something like that? They said it's not a bolt action, it's a spring loaded like freaking crossbow style pistol. I'm kind of thinking to myself, I'm like, why didn't they just throw a crossbow in there? But they did that before and it didn't really fly so big time with the community. But dual wielding light machine guns, damn. Dual wielding light machine guns, that's, I mean, you're going Terminator style with something like that. Yeah, I mean, what more can you say really, other than this Advanced Warfare is going to be a breath of fresh air in a series that has been running kind of stale. I've said it before in my other videos. I thought MW3 was a camp fest. Black Ops 2 had major connection problems, and Ghosts was the first time where they kind of brought it back. It was like a throwback to COD 4, and there's a lot of people that probably disagree with me on that, but it's all the it's because the general public on Ghosts, it just slowed the game down so much because nobody wants to move. Everybody's sitting back camping on Ghosts, and it's just, and that's the public playing it that way. It's not the game developers making Ghosts slow. Me, if you watch my videos, I'm flying all over that map and I'm getting, all kinds of kills. I'm coming in first place all the time because of the way I play. And everybody else is just kind of, they're almost like a step behind because they play it so slowly. Maybe it's just because the public, because Call of Duty's gotten so big, maybe it's just the general public is, it's kind of like newer gamers coming in and everybody's trying to learn how to go as quick. I mean, I've been on the series since COD 4 back in the day. There's people probably on there since COD 1 that would, knowing I'm really in the essence of what I'm talking about there. The game is not going to be slow if the general public doesn't play it slowly. Like, if you watch the pros, Ghosts is like so quick and so fast paced and everything. Like a blitz game on Ghosts. You watch the pros, they're getting in almost like 20 some odd scores. You watch the general public playing it, you're lucky if you see 10. And it's like, that's why it's called blitz. A blitz move is to run and go quick and, get the goal and what, and it's just the way people try and play the game. They try and go so much on the defensive side of stuff that I think the general public has kind of like, for the last, well, I wanted to say Ghosts anyways, because Black Ops 2 was, it started, and then Ghosts is where it was like, ugh, everybody just drew it out. Like, I'm not even gonna name out maps or and all that stuff for Ghosts. But like I said, if you play the game fast, it's gonna be a fast-paced, high-action game. If you play it slow, which the general public usually does, it's gonna be that type of game. It's just all depends on the public, and hopefully, Advanced Warfare, as I said in the last, the first reaction video to Advanced Warfare, I'm gonna definitely be checking out, and you'll probably be seeing it popping up on the channel too. I'm gonna be checking out some Battlefield series. They got Battlefield 4 with the EA access for very cheap now. They got Battlefield Hardline coming out, and of course from Activision we got Destiny coming out. So I'm gonna be checking out those, and yeah, Destiny's at MMO, so that could just very well be, a second first-person shooter to throw up on the channel. Battlefield, like, I really love Battlefield 3. I heard so much bad stuff about Battlefield 4, I never even tried to pick it up. And now that EA Access is out, like, they got kind of like Madden and Battlefield, which, nine times out of ten, that's what everybody's going for. So, I'm gonna definitely look into trying to get that so I can do, some James Lewis series Madden stuff, some Battlefield 4 gameplays, whatnot, and Yeah, just if those, if Destiny for some reason flops, which I don't really see it flopping, but if for some reason it does, because we never know with shooters nowadays, especially when they're play off the internet servers and whatnot, like Titanfall. Titanfall, that's another one that I think is really just kind of like, after they updated it, they listened to the community so much that it kind of broke the game. And that's another one too. I hope if Advanced Warfare is very balanced and everything else, I hope that, I mean, I can see if there's a major problem, like there's like a one weapon that is majorly like overpowered and everything, that is just wrecking every other weapon out there. If there's extremes in the game, I hope they level those out. But for the most part, I would hope that they wouldn't listen to the public, and if they got a very nice, well balanced, very good flowing game, that they don't update and mess that up. And the other one too is if their servers are working pretty decent, because Ghosts, I find servers, if you play it on Xbox One, Call of Duty Ghosts works like it runs so smooth and everything. You do have games that drop out and stuff. It's the internet. It's online. It's gonna happen. It's gonna piss you off when it does happen, but it's gonna happen. And it's totally night and day from 360. And I think that's where also Ghosts kind of fell short, because I noticed there was a lot more lag. There was a lot more issues with connection on Ghosts for the 360 than there is on the Xbox One. It's like I said, it's like a night and day difference. Like you go on the 360 and you're gonna be, lagging out. You're gonna have games dropped and everything else. Xbox One, you're gonna be able to hop around there with your friends and run and have probably, I want to say, 80% of the night is gonna be very decent for connection wise. And I think it's because of the other, it's the new types of servers that they got for Xbox One that helps it out a lot too. Which hopefully that transitions over to Advanced Warfare, and makes that, that seamless transition over, if you want to say that, and that the servers hold up very well on Advanced Warfare. Do I see Advanced Warfare selling as good as the other ones? It's really almost hard to say, because there's been so much criticism on the Call of Duty series since Ghost. I think now that the pros have been showing it off, I think that they got a good chance of topping off sales, that way. Like I said, esports, it just it makes you want to play it. Like they, the pros playing it. It's such a good, it shows all the best selling points in the game. And it's really, I mean, hell, the pro boot camp is just the pros playing around. They do get competitive once they get to knowing the game, but for the most part, it's just like, if everybody took a note off the pros and started running around really quick, started playing the game a lot, more fast paced than what they usually do, or they have been doing on Ghost. I can see Advanced Warfare being, a very mighty title in the series. Possibly, maybe the best of the series. Because it is, I wouldn't say Ghost by any means is revolutionizing anything in gaming or anything like that. I would say it's getting itself up to date to the new titles. And that's what was kind of missing in Ghosts, because it was just like one of those things where the developers, they had all these ideas, but the ideas were done before, but at the same time, the new ideas had already been done by other companies. And I think that's where everybody's like, well, yeah, we've done that. We've seen that. We're seeing that again in Advanced Warfare. There are Titanfall stuff, like the jetpacks and everything else, the double jump abilities are taken out, a lot off from, that type of thing. The Halo matchup, that, the brand new matchup we're seeing on the pro boot camp and all that stuff, where you're throwing the balls through the hoop and all that. I mean, yeah, like I said, it's going to copy out from other titles, just like other titles copy out from it. But, you know, at the end of the day, if, you know, the general public plays at really fast pace and they make the game the right way, it should be a very, very cool experience and a very fun experience for everybody that actually sits down and picks up Advanced Warfare. So, that's my almost half hour of talking about the game. 3 days worth of watching the pros playing around with it. And, yeah, just seeing the whole nine yards. You know, that's a lot of this stuff is just my opinions, too. You know, people, you know, you probably have a different opinion. Maybe you have the same opinion. Maybe I just, you know, spark some ideas in your head. You know, whatever the case may be, you know, shout out on the Twitters, shout out on the Facebooks, and, of course, the developers are going to end up checking in and listening, especially on the Twitter. I've been noticing a lot more developers going to Twitter than on the Facebook. Probably be an easy way of checking in with all of them. Anyways, so, you know what to do. This is the end slate. Wolfhead's going to bring it to the main page of the channel. Click on the videos that are running on the screen. It's going to bring you to that video. And it's the latest video, you know, for that system, for the 360 or Xbox One. And yes, the Retro Gamer series, still in the works. Hopefully it's going to pan out. And I will probably, I'll end up leaving a link in the video for the Advanced Warfare website, so you can check out the Advanced Warfare website itself. So yeah, if you like this video, drop that like, that thumbs up, drop a comment if you want to, share the video and all that stuff, and of course, you know, if you subscribe to the channel, it's going to make sure that you stay tuned for more videos, as always, coming soon.